The Wonderful Wizard of Oz by L. Frank Baum. Dorothy lived in the midst of the great Kansas prairies with Uncle Henry, who was a farmer, and Aunt Em, who was the farmer's wife. Their house was small. There were four walls, a floor, a roof, a cook stove, cupboard, table, chairs, a big bed in one corner, and a little bed in another. There was no cellar, except a small hole in the ground, called a cyclone cellar, where the family could go in case one of those great whirlwinds arose, mighty enough to crush any building in its path. It was reached by a trap door in the middle of the floor. When Dorothy stood in the doorway and looked around, she could see nothing but the great gray prairie. Not a tree nor a house broke the sweep of flat country that reached to the edge of the sky in all directions. Once the house had been painted, but the sun blistered the paint, and the rains washed it away, and now the house was as dull and gray as everything else. The sun and wind had changed Aunt Em, too. They had taken the sparkle from her eyes and the red from her cheeks and lips. She was thin and gaunt, and never smiled now. When Dorothy, who was an orphan, first came to her, Aunt Em had been so startled by the child's laughter that she would scream and press her hand upon her heart, and she still looked at the little girl with wonder that she could find anything to laugh at. Uncle Henry never laughed. He worked hard from morning till night, and he was gray also, from his long beard to his rough boots. It was Toto that made Dorothy laugh. He was a little black dog with long silky hair and small black eyes. Toto played all day long, and Dorothy played with him. Today, however, they were not playing. Uncle Henry sat upon the doorstep and looked anxiously at the sky. From the far north, they heard a low wail of the wind, and Uncle Henry and Dorothy could see where the long grass bowed in waves before the coming storm. There now came a sharp whistling in the air from the south, and they saw ripples in the grass coming from that direction also. Suddenly, Uncle Henry stood up.
"There's a cyclone coming, Em. I'll go look after the stock."
He ran toward the sheds where the cows and horses were kept. Aunt Em dropped her work and came to the door.
"Quick, Dorothy! Run for the cellar!"
Toto jumped out of Dorothy's arms and hid under the bed. Aunt Em threw open the trap door in the floor and climbed down the ladder. Dorothy caught Toto at last, and when she was halfway across the room, there came a great shriek from the wind, and the house shook so hard that she lost her footing and sat down suddenly. Then, a strange thing happened. The house whirled around two or three times and rose slowly through the air. Dorothy felt as if she were going up in a balloon. The north and south winds met where the house stood and made it the exact center of the cyclone. In the middle of a cyclone, the air is generally still, but the great pressure of the wind on every side of the house raised it up higher and higher until it was at the very top of the cyclone, and there it remained and was carried miles and miles away as easily as you could carry a feather. It was very dark, and the wind howled around her, but Dorothy felt as if she were being rocked gently, like a baby in a cradle. Toto did not like it. He ran about, barking loudly. Once Toto got too near the open trap door and fell in, but the strong pressure of the air was keeping him up, so the little girl crept to the hole, caught Toto by the ear, and dragged him into the room again, afterward closing the trap door so that no more accidents could happen. Hour after hour passed away, and Dorothy felt quite lonely. At first she had wondered if she would be dashed to pieces when the house fell again, but as the hours passed and nothing terrible happened, she resolved to wait calmly and see what the future would bring. At last she crawled over the swaying floor to her bed and Toto followed and lay down beside her. In spite of the swaying of the house and the wailing of the wind, Dorothy soon closed her eyes and fell fast asleep.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.